watercolour course. Today we will be painting this lovely Hay Bales picture. We'll be using Cadmium Yellow, Cadmium Red and Ultramarine Blue. If you do have yellow ochre or burnt sienna, that would be a lot easier for you. You won't need to mix quite so much and it will keep your colours cleaner. So what I wanted to do was show you, this is yellow ochre and this is burnt sienna. If you have a solid palette, like I know a lot of you do have at home, these are very, very common colours and they often come in the simple solid palettes. If you have tubes of paint, again, if you've bought it as a set, you'll often find that the yellow ochre especially, and occasionally the burnt sienna, are contained in that set. So hopefully you guys have got those colours there. It's just going to make things a lot easier. But to begin with, I will show you how you can mix those two colours with the three primaries. So if I bring my palette across, spot of water, and I'm just going to use my small brush, number 6 brush here. I'm just going to show you how to mix, first of all, this yellow ochre colour. So cadmium yellow to begin with. Okay. And you can see it's a pale colour. So we just need a little of the red, the cadmium red, just to warm it up slightly. Tiny bit more. And then we'll use a spot of the ultramarine blue. I've pre-wet these paints, so they're already sort of activated in my palette there. That was a spot of the ultramarine blue. We could go a little more with that. Dab off my paint. There we go. Just go a tiny bit further with the blue. And if I show you on a piece of paper here, pretty much got a yellow ochre colour. It's very similar. Could warm it up a little bit. We could go for a touch more of the red. Warmed it up a fair bit there. So if we go again, there we go. That's very, very similar to my yellow ochre, which I already have in my palette, just down here. And if you want to create the darker shade, which is this burnt sienna colour, I have that across here on my palette, you just use the same three colours, but in a slightly different percentage of each colour. So this one, the darker colour, will have more red, so we'll add more red to the mix. And obviously to make this really dark, we go for more of the ultramarine blue. Pick up a fair bit of that blue. And straight away you can see that that's a much darker colour. So we're aiming this time to get a burnt sienna, which is over here, and actually we are almost there with that burnt sienna. Okay, so those colours are easy to mix with the three primaries. So that's the cadmium yellow, cadmium red and ultramarine blue. And we've created our own yellow ochre here and a burnt sienna there. So throughout this painting we're going to be using a lot of natural colours. If I take you back to the reference image here, it's a lot of oranges, a lot of these yellow ochre colours and burnt siennas within this image. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use those colours from my palette rather than mixing. However, hopefully I've just shown you how to do that, so if you don't have those colours you should be able to create them yourself in your palette. We're also going to be creating this really moody, I'd say, moody sky, really. Quite dark but also brilliant light coming through. So that's going to be our first step. Right, so the first step is to scribble on the back of your reference image that you've printed off at home and place that on top of your paper, line it up where you'd like it. and then trace through. I've only traced in the horizon line just so that I have a guideline to work to when I create the wash of the sky. And I've also penciled in the shape of that hay bale there and also that one in the distance. I'm not at all worried about those hay bales right in the very end of the field across the other side there. They're way too small to worry about, so we're going to leave those out of our painting. So once you trace that through, you should have something a little bit like this. So just using a normal HB pencil to trace that through, and obviously to do scribbling on the back if you have a graphite stick, that works really well. Alternatively, you can use a HB pencil but press on quite hard, so there's a lot of graphite transferred onto the back of your sheet, because it's this that you're pressing onto the surface of the paper, and that's what really reveals the image there. So we're going to create the lovely wash of the sky, and I bring back my palette. Just going to dab off that colour there. That's my demonstration for you guys, so that you know how to mix the burnt sienna and the yellow ochre. So get rid of that. Okay, so if we look at our reference image, there's lots of colour, lots of things happening. What we're going to do is we're going to work wet in wet so that we have lovely soft edges. And we're going to create something quite dark, dark blue, using the ultramarine and a little bit of the burnt sienna to give it that dark colour. We aren't going to mix something this dark, I think that's too dark for our painting, so I'm going to kind of use this kind of dark blue colour all across the top there as well. And we're going to have this beautiful yellow streaming through too. But in actual fact, we're going to do it in two steps. We're going to create the blue first, allow that to fully dry, and then we're going to bring in these oranges and yellows over the top. So to mix up our blue, spot of water in the palette, and I'm just using my number 12 round brush here, and I want to pick up ultramarine blue first. Let's get some pigment going. We want this fairly dark, nice and dark on the image, and the more pigment you have now the less you'll have to do to sort of create that depth of colour. You might need to put extra washes on if it's not dark enough at this stage, so really don't be afraid to go for a lot of pigment in here, and remember it will dry a lot lighter than it is when it's on the palette. So I've got a decent amount of blue in there, it's still very liquid. Clean my brush off a little. And I'm coming across into my burnt sienna across here. I'm just going to pick up a little bit of that and mix that in. Excuse me. You can see straight away how dark that makes the blue there. And if I just show you on my scrap piece of paper, let's have a look. So at the moment it's very, very thin, but it is nice and dark. So what we're gonna do is just work on the amount of pigment that's in the mix. So I'm just gonna pick up, work away at that paint, pick up a lot of pigment and bring it across into that wash. Remember, we're also gonna be working wet into wet. So this paint is gonna be in effect diluted by the water that's on the page. So again, you don't want to be afraid of picking up a lot of pigment here so you get that depth of colour. Okay, so that's made quite a warm colour there, so going back into the ultramarine blue again now, because that's not quite blue enough, it's a little bit too brown. Pick up some more of that. Dab off your paintbrush in between washing it in the water, because you don't want to excuse my phone there, you don't want to dilute the solution in between each go, because obviously the aim here is to thicken up your paint. That's much better. So if I show you now what I've created, base. That's much thicker in pigment, so it should create quite a nice moody backdrop to our painting. Okay, so I'm going to push that to one side. So this is a sable brush. It's got natural bristles. It holds a lot of water, so I use this all the time really for wetting my paper. What I want you to do when you wet your paper is to start at the top, nice long even strokes coming down the paper, but don't allow any of this water to go into the shape of your hay bale. The better you control the water at this stage, the less work you'll have to do to correct any mistakes. As soon as you apply paint to the paper that's wet, it wants to flood into any wet areas, but it won't go into any of the dry areas, so it's a great way of controlling what happens to the paint. Again, just be careful around your hay bale there, that little one in the distance. Make sure you're not missing any gaps. You want a nice even coat of water on the paper. And because I'm under lights, it will dry quite quickly. So I'm just going to carry on making sure I've got an even distribution of water there. It's not completely soaking wet, there's not puddles. I just have a damp surface to apply my paint to. Okay, I've just got a hair there, so I'm going to get rid of that before I start. That's it. So the trick here is to have an even coat as you possibly can, which is good, and also you don't want any puddles. Want a sheen across your page. If you tilt the page, you should be able to see if you've missed any areas at all. And this is where you want to get your round brush. Again, you don't want it sopping wet because it's going to dilute your mixture. So go into the paint that you've mixed. It's ultramarine blue, so just give it a mix in the palette just to bring it all together again. And I'm going to start in the top left section of my painting. I really want to apply this lovely dark colour. Get that on the surface, allow it to move across the surface. And it's creating these lovely soft shapes. You don't have to create a sky that's exactly like the one in the picture, but just use it as a guide, because it's creating lovely soft areas. It's nice to have a bit of a diagonal coming across the page. It gives you some depth, sort of a receding into the distance with the sky. So you can see I've got a lovely soft edge to that. It's just what we wanted. And I'm going to up more paint, leaving a gap in the middle, as you can see on the reference image. Just going to bring in some paint on this side, working my way up to, I'm just going to get a smaller brush just to come down to that detail around on the surface. I don't want to puddle, I don't want too much paint. That detail there, just bring it up to the edge. Starting to dry, it's not moving so much on the surface, so I'm going to work a bit quicker. I've got some lovely dark sections there, which is fine. We just re-wet this section with my clean brush, just to damp this area a little bit more, get those soft edges that I need. So just re-wet that section. It's a little bit too wet, just come in with your that. So back into my dark colour now. I know I've got nice damp area to work on, and you can see that just wants to run off the tip of the brush there and create those fuzzy, fuzzy lines, which is just beautiful. So my paper is buckling a little, so I just want to be mindful that I don't want to create any puddles here. So I'm going to place that paint down across the horizon line, missing obviously that hay bale there. That's it. I think that's fine. You can kind of come in with a little bit more paint if you need to. Just dab it on here and there just to darken up some spots. And come back into this section at the top. Add a little bit more paint just to darken it up here and there. You can only do this while it's wet. If you come back in and it starts to dry, you'll end up with some hard edges, which we don't want. So just be mindful of how quickly you're painting. If you go to put some paint down and it doesn't move on the surface, if it doesn't spread softly, then your painting is starting to dry and you need to leave it then. You can't really touch it and you'll end up with hard edges. So what you need to do is just let it dry completely, come back and wet the surface again, and you can apply some darker paint where you want it. You don't need to mess with it too much, I'm quite happy with that. Just bring in just some slightly darker paint. That's great. So now what we need to do is allow this to dry and come back to it in a little while. Just before I go, just bear in mind that you want to clean the edges of your paper so that you don't get any paint pulling back onto your paper as it's drying, creating those blooms. Just go around the edges, wipe off that excess, and that way you